Hello viewers, I'm Harsha Guntala from Belzo TV. Great breath, speaking breath, silent breath and stepping breath. Yes, dear friends, I'm talking about Neil Armstrong, the first person who landed on the moon in 1969. So today, I would like you to know from the person, project manager Mr. J.P. Joshi, who was working as a project manager in ISRO. And we would like to know about ISRO journey from this person. So, Mr. Joshi, welcome to Belzo TV studio. And my viewers, my audience would like to know about the journey of ISRO in space.
Okay, so thank you and hello viewers. I'm J.P. Joshi.
Okay.
I have worked in ISRO for about 39 years.
My God! Wonderful experience.
Yeah, it is an unforgettable experience.
Yeah. We all, I mean to say me as well as the audience, all are dreaming about the news, whatever you are releasing in the world.
Yeah, but whatever fascinating stories or news we hear today,
mm-hmm.
In the open domain,
yeah,
there is a lot of hard work has gone into behind each and every person involved with ISRO.
Right.
And the story began in early 60s.
Okay.
Where nobody has even thought of, even S of science was not very popular.
right.
We used to import wheat from US.
Oh, I see.
Right.
And
can you imagine at that point of time, there was a one person
mm-hmm.
who had a vision for future India.
Okay.
And who had a thought
mm-hmm.
that if in future, if a country like India has to develop and prosper,
mm-hmm.
then communication satellite is the only means
that
a country
that person?
Like, okay, I'm coming to that. That
okay.
is none other.
We are anxious to know about, isn't it?
And he is considered to be the father of Indian space program, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai.
Wow, Dr. Vikram Sarabhai is the person who got a thought.
Yes.
About
yeah.
it. Okay.
And then he approached the government and he told that okay, we should go ahead in this direction and we should explore this.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, he was given a green signal and
mm-hmm.
he started working on it. And on those days,
mm-hmm.
he had a vision.
Okay.
That we should not directly think that at that time the other developed nations were far ahead in space race.
Yes, yes.
But we had to just begin.
Yeah.
So what he thought, ISRO should not jump directly in making a satellite or making a rocket or
okay.
launching it into space. But
okay.
what is ultimately needed, if a satellite is available in space,
mm.
how effectively can you use for an Indian landmass?
Okay.
So with that as a vision.
So I would like to say that in the beginning, you were using other countries' satellite, right?
Exactly, it was ATS-6. That was hired.
Okay.
It was American satellite. We hired the
American
satellite
was hired. How otherwise nowadays we are taking other satellite in the space, right?
That is a reality.
yeah. Little bit I know about it.
Correct, good. And that is what we think, that whatever ISRO is today,
mm-hmm.
it should be in knowledge of each and every countryman. That is what.
Yeah, that is true.
So that we took the help of that satellite and we established that how a effective satellite communication can be used for literacy period of the underdeveloped people and
okay.
society like India. That was our starting
yeah.
point. Then we moved on and afterwards
mm-hmm.
we had a roadmap. Okay, now we have acquired how to use a satellite. So
yeah.
ISRO's unique selling point or the main thing is
mm-hmm.
before making anything, you should be well aware how exactly you would be using it. Can you really use it? Because it's a very risky and expensive business.
Cross
of a beast.
Yes.
And fate of a nation. So,
if anything we are buying from the market, we should know for what we are buying.
Exactly. So
what we are going to make out of it. If at all, suppose we are buying the vegetable or wheat, what you were saying that previously we were getting export imported from USA, our wheat. So that way we were knowing what to make out of wheat, what to make out of potatoes in the same way, how to make the use of satellite. That was required to know by the Indian people who are working on the project.
So having acquired that knowledge and effective skill, ISRO decided to make their own satellite.
Right, very
so
good.
So ISRO designed a series of satellite that was known as INSAT-1 series satellite.
INSAT-1.
And that was design was Indian, but it was produced or it was manufactured by US for Ford Aerospace.
Okay.
We did not make because we did not have the facility of building the satellite.
Right.
So on our design, we got it fabricated by Ford Aerospace. It was INSAT-1 series.
Okay.
So, but then INSAT-2 series, we decided, okay, we will have our own satellite.
Yeah.
And the starting point of the Indian communication satellite journey, especially for communication satellite.
Yeah.
The first communication satellite built by ISRO, whose name was Apple.
Wow.
Not this Apple, not what we use. Not that Apple, but Apple, known as Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment.
Wow.
So it was
Ariane Passenger Payload
Experiment. Okay, I will tell you how this name came.
Yeah.
Because we did not.
That is interesting, isn't it, people?
So we made a satellite. It was a very primary satellite of having only two transponder, 500 kg of weight.
Uh-huh.
And we know that, okay, it is an experimental satellite.
Yeah,
we made it in
1975. Baby satellite.
We started making it.
Yeah.
So, sorry, 78 we made it.
Mm-hmm.
And 1980 it was launched.
Wow.
And my journey in ISRO started with the design of that satellite in 1978. So, I am
so
with ISRO.
You were the designer?
Yeah, one of the subsystems known as amplifier, I was one of the designer.
Wow.
So, my journey started with the first communication satellite of ISRO till I was an associate.
So, audience, I would like to inform audience, Mr. J.P. Joshi is the first person who designed the satellite of ISRO.
So then that because we did not have the rocket to fly, rocket to put the satellite into space. So that time ESA, European Space Agency, had a rocket called Ariane.
Okay.
So because they did not have much customer, they already have one customer and the space was still there. So they offered India that we will fly your satellite for free. And that is what we wanted.
Very good, very good.
So it was a
without
free ride.
Any rent
without
any charges.
Without any charges. So it was a free ride.
Yeah.
So we accepted it.
Mm-hmm.
And that is why it is an Ariane, the name of the rocket.
Okay.
Passenger, because we are not the buyer. So we become a passenger.
Yeah.
Payload means a small satellite and experiment. So Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment.
Right.
Apple.
Okay.
So their journey started. It was first communication satellite launched in 1980.
Mm-hmm.
And then we made INSAT-1 series, INSAT-2 series.
Yeah, yeah.
And we started with, in technical term, with a very low frequency that is called S-band. Then we moved on to C-band.
Mm-hmm.
Now we have moved on to K-band, which is very largely used by all the users today. That is your dish TV, or we call it DTH, direct to home service. That is generally at K-band. So now we are using Ku-band, and for futuristic satellite we have also started working on Ka-band payload, right? So in many of our satellite, Ka-band satellite is also there. So this is the journey of ISRO. For communication, this is what I briefed you, but at the same time, the first satellite made by ISRO was in 1975, and that was Bhaskara.
Bhaskara.
Bhaskara, named
name
after
of the satellite.
It was named after a great mathematician.
Bhaskara.
So Aryabhatta and Bhaskara were the two satellites made in 1975 and soon after. They were the first remote sensing kind of satellite. And then the journey started also in the field of remote sensing.
Okay.
Now the first real remote sensing satellite when it was flown in space, the idea was to observe the satellite from a remote place, about 500 to 1000 kilometers. From that height, if you look at the Earth, you get lot many information.
Right?
So you don't have to go to Ahmedabad, Bombay, Bangalore every day and take pictures of
your
forest or say your crops and your field and get information. But satellite sitting at that height can see the entire India at a time. Right?
Entire India
at a time. So we started that. But I tell you one very interesting part that when we first developed the camera, the resolution of that camera of remote sensing satellite was 1 kilometer.
Okay.
So that is considered to be a poor resolution. That if you have a picture of 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer, then only you can find some information in that picture. You cannot zoom. Image is distorted. But today, whatever camera, sensor, what ISRO is developing, is having a resolution of 1 meter.
Wow.
So journey of 1 kilometer to 1 meter is not overnight. It has taken 40 years of sweat and blood behind this development.
So many people.
It's a teamwork. And tomorrow's...
Nearly how many persons must be working in whole ISRO? 10,000, 5,000, 1,000?
Okay, it's about 20,000. Comprises of engineers, scientists, technicians, then administration, then business management.
But how you got the knowledge of entering into ISRO? When you entered for the interview or whatever it is, before that what you thought for entering into ISRO?
To be very frank, I did not have any knowledge about ISRO. When I